Good day to audience around the world. Welcome to Professional Yi Jing Feng Shui TV Station, Weixin TV Station. I'm Clara Ho. Today is Monday, November 5th, 2018. It's now 11:30 p.m. in Taiwan. Let's start from our news today with when Master Wen Yuan chances for Ping at the one-day Zen event with thousands of Buddhas. This event is regularly held on 4th Sunday every month.
维新圣教 One Day Event with Thousand Buddhas was held on the 28th at the Thousand Buddha Zen Hall. The event was broadcast online to all branch temples in Taiwan. Virtuous fellows around the island are tuning to Grand Master Wen Yuan Chan's lecture on the wisdom of the Diamond Sutra and receive enlightenment on the ultimate wondrous Dharma. It is hoped that all can attain Buddha enlightenment and reach the pure land of the ultimate bliss. 维新圣教 One Day Zen Event with Thousand Buddhas routinely takes place on the fourth Sunday of each month. In light of the increasing number of virtuous fellows, the Zen event is broadcast online to all branch temples to save the trouble of a community from different parts of Taiwan. Meanwhile, fellow members of the branch temple classroom take turns to attend the Dharma Propagation at Xianfo Temple. Grand Master Wen Yuan Chan's instructions at the event on the 28th are as follows.
时间过得很快，一天一天都过去，又要一年了。所以时间的岁月就是不饶人，大家都很清楚。但是这是诸佛菩萨、诸天人想要来世间体验人生的最宝贵的，因为人在世间上，你所体验一天的时间，就在天上界你要一年，才能体会到世间的一天的所有酸甜苦辣涩。所以有的人很埋怨说：“哎呀，我在世间啊，生活这么苦，啊，在世间要吃也吃不到，爱也爱不到，拿也拿不到，得也得不到。”这个呢，叫做娑婆世界。娑婆世界啊，啊，所以当一旦我们大限到的时候，你又念念不忘世间的这些经验，而即使再有机会再走一趟，也甘愿再来走一趟，即使三餐不济，也是甘愿来接受。可是爱莫能助，所以老祖师尊导教慈航常常在提醒我们所有的有缘的人，要珍惜世间的每一段时间，即使当一天的乞丐，也要为众生、为他人来做利他的事情。所以就有释迦牟尼，他放弃世间的名利富贵、财富所悟到的真理呀，他到处弘法，告诉大家能放弃世间的一切执着，要往智慧啊去开发出来。
In simple words, Grandmaster shared insights of the purpose of life. It is Grandmaster's hope that all virtuous fellows and the general public can come to the awareness of the real meaning of the practice in life and how precious cultivation is. People should take actions to benefit others and develop independent wisdom that lets life be in vain. 微信 news 南投
Grandmaster 混元禅师 entrusts that different religions are endowed with different providence. All religions seek to attain common good for the society only use respective expertise. In 微信圣教 feature story, you will learn about the correlation between 易经风水 and everything else. You will also be learning the wisdom of 易经风水 obligation and E divination from the true stories we are sharing with you.
Ladies and gentlemen, 阿弥陀佛 Welcome for watching 微信圣教 feature story.Today, we are going to share the story of how Grandmaster 混元禅师 solved follows problem. Over 10 years ago, 混元禅师 visited a family in Yilan to have feng shui exploration. This family had a spacious land and a big garden. The house was well designed. However, there was a collapsed geographical feature. 6 years later, after moving in this place,The career of the house owner was full of obstacles. His child also suffered from a psychological problem. The house owner told 混元禅师that he had invited 6 geographic professionals to explore. All of them had their own explanation. Everything still went wrong. 混元禅师told him to consider about karma if problem happened.He can reflect about how many good deeds have been done. If enough charity was performed, they will receive help in the right timing. The house was built on a collapsed land. Such land is called 绝地 or 瘴土. The whole family will decline as a whole if they continue living at such place. The only solution is to fill up the collapsed area.混元禅师 learned feng shui from Master Shen Kong, Li Shu Yu. He was always reminded by his master that he should preach the right dharma. He should not preach those dharma unbeneficial to public. Preaching the right dharma can save a family or even a nationality and vice versa. Tang Zhen Yi, the head of San Yuan Jindan, is a master of 混元禅师。He died in his 90s. He had his own real story to prove that feng shui is not superstitious. It can really help us getting rid of any unfortune and misery. People were told there was a house in Yonghe having ghosts inside. On one day to move in, there would be spiritual fire flying in every night. After exploring the house, Master Tan,found that it had a good feng shui. However, the previous owner wrongly set the door location. There was a cave near the door. Bad energy was originated from the tiger side. He then purchased that house and rearranged the lower location. Early after moving into the house, his neighbors still saw spiritual fire kept flying into the house along the same route.But they were blocked by the closed tiger door and vanished after all. Those fires gradually reduced in number and no more could be seen after a period of time. Master Tan told his neighbors that in fact there were no spiritual stuffs. All the abnormal phenomenon was due to inappropriate feng shui. The previous house owner wrongly decided the door location.His family declined from prosperity. But then Master Tan adjusted a little bit to comply with feng shui principle. Everything went smooth. Master Tan had been living there for a long time. Everything goes well. It is evidently true that following feng shui principles can get home peace. Thank you for watching today's feature story. Bless you all. See you next time.
Take a break. We will come back soon. Weixin Shenjia Research and Development Center for Religious Affairs is actively in touch with international community in an effort to join events on the topic of world religion and the religious education. Coming up next, a detailed report on Weixin Shenjia Delegation's visit to Daejeon University of Korea.From October 20th to 24th to join the Second World Xiangshen Forum.
On October 20th, Master Yuan Qing, Master Yuan Tong, and Master Yuan Tang, represent Weixin Shenjia, went to Korea to attend the Second World Xiangshen Forum. The theme topic of the Second World Xiangshen Forum is Towards an Earthly Paradise. Many scholars from around the world, such as USA, United Kingdom, France, China, Russia, Canada,Japan, Sweden, Lithuania, Italy, and Korea attended the forum and present papers to explore the possibility of paradise on Earth and its way to form. The World Xiangshen Forum, hosted by Daejeon Academy of Sciences of Daejeon Junior Hall as Korea Daejeon University, started from 2017. The theme of the forum was resolution of grievances for mutual beneficence.They wish the forum can be a platform for the exchange between the Western and Eastern religious scholars and can be the best to let the concept of Daejeon spread in the world. Through this forum, the friendship between Weixin Shenjia and Daejeon Junior Hall will be more stable and also enhance the understanding with delegation of Gaodai. In a reception, Master Yuan Qing said that living happily at present is living in the paradise.To respond to the topic of this forum, earning the big applause of participants, in the end, the participants were arranged to visit the headquarters and the branches of Daejeon Junior Hall, also the Korea Demilitarized Zone. Weixin News, Korea.
Yilan Branch Temple above Master Yuan Hui and the Virtuous Pharaohs has been dedicating their effort for 4 years to the preparation of Weixin Shenjia Danshui Branch Temple.Following Wang Chan Lao Zhu's definite will and the Grandmaster Wen Yuan Chan's instructions, the groundbreaking ceremony was held in an auspicious timing on the most appropriate day. The ceremony marks the official start of the temple's construction. Here is more on the ceremony.
One of Weixin Shenjia's 16 Dharma sources and 48 great vows is constructing branch temples for recruiting talented people and cultivating virtuous fellows to turn the Dharma wheel of world peace together. On October 25th, the groundbreaking ceremony for constructing Weixin Shenjia Danshui branch temple was held at its anticipated location, Longquan Building.In the future, Danshui Branch Temple will be located on the fifth floor of Longquan Building. It will be the place to turn the Dharma wheel of promoting Yi Jing Feng Shui education and propagating the wondrous Dharma of Wang Chan Lao Zhu in saving sentient beings by making everyone healthy, every family safe, the society harmonious, and the nation peaceful.Longquan Building was constructed by the virtuous follower Guo Zhuan. Mr. Guo made a great wish to donate more than 400 pins on the fifth floor of the building for establishing Danshui Branch Temple. It will be a temple for virtuous fellows and followers near Danshui area to cultivate themselves in the religious practice. After the future completion of the temple,It will be sitting in the Mao direction and facing Yao, that is sitting in the east direction and facing west. However, good things always suffer before they come through. After the first groundbreaking ceremony, it encountered the incident of Tainan's Wei Guan building collapsed after the earthquake. For structural and safety concern, Longquan building has been completely redesigned.Then it encountered the year of Sansha, which is the year with three negative energies, and is not an auspicious year for construction. Finally, it broke ground on the 25th and began the construction of the temple under the great wish and the blessings of Buddhas and Bodhisattvas.
非常感谢呢，咱这个龙津大楼哈，因这个整个申请兴建的过程哈，其实他们要做一个好代志哈，是要持之以恒的哈。啊，这次总算呢，已经往那个正确的方向哦，在前进哈。哦，所以希望这个等一下预祝龙津大楼的新建能够施工顺利啊。
The abbot of Danshui Branch Temple, Master Yuan Hui, was appreciated and said, Mr. Guo was also very grateful to the help of Wang Chan Lao Zhu and Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi in planning the layout of the building according to the feng shui principles to make the building safe. Master Yuan Meng of Wei Xin Sheng Jiao Chanting College led the chanters to recite scriptures to offer to the spirits in 10 directions of Dharma Rim in the groundbreaking ceremony. Afterwards, Mr. Guo broke ground to start the construction. The rite was completed successfully. We sincerely pray for all the follow-up construction will be safe and complete with success. Wei Xin News, Danshui.
Take a break. We will come back soon. Next, we have the news on the ratio for the birthday celebration of a Guan Yin Bodhisattva in Wei Xin Sheng Jiao Branch Temple. Let's have a look.
Guan Yin Bodhisattva's monk day falls on the 18th day of the ninth month in the lunar calendar. On this day, all branch temples of Wei Xin Sheng Jiao prepare fragrant flowers, fresh foods, longevity peach buns, longevity noodles, and the feasty Dharma offerings for the benediction ritual for Guan Yin Bodhisattva's Monk Day and celebrate Guan Yin Bodhisattva's birthday. At the ritual for birthday celebration of Guan Yin Bodhisattva, all virtuous fellows piously chanted Wang Chan Lao Zhu profound scripture and the universal door of Guan Yin Bodhisattva and prayed for favorable weather, prosperity of our country, and safety of the people. Besides, we prayed that Wang Chan Lao Zhu, Guan Yin Bodhisattva, Buddhas, Bodhisattva sages, and deities would place Taiwan with safety, prevent it from natural disasters, plagues, hunger, and war, and bless Grandmaster with being safe and well. Wei Xin Sheng Jiao has much to do with Guan Yin Bodhisattva. 36 years ago, following Guan Yin Bodhisattva's instruction, Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi opened Violent Heavenly Gate at Mount Jiawu in Taichung, and Buddhas, Bodhisattva sages and deities then descended to Taiwan to roll the Dharma realm, which initiated Wei Xin Sheng Jiao's mission to eliminate disasters and resolve grievance. During the past 36 years, Grandmaster has been leading virtuous fellows to follow the instruction from the heaven and perform Dharma. Thus, we have eliminated loss of nature and man-made disasters. Now, in the 37th year, we received the mission to stop wars arising from starvation and poverty in the world from Jade Emperor at the seat completion ceremony of Dafan Branch Temple. As Guan Yin Bodhisattva mercifully kept Grandmaster from harm 36 years ago. Thus, all of Wei Xin Sheng Jiao's virtuous fellows show great gratitude to Guan Yin Bodhisattva's mercy on salvation. Wei Xin News.
On August 3, 2018, Wei Xin World Courts performed in collaboration with Wen Xiaoxuan, a reputable traditional music band in Taiwan, at an annual music concert named Da Duan Caprice. The concert features local ballads presented in the ensemble of chords and traditional Chinese instruments. Following Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi's instructions, the performers will be featured in the Chinese United Ancestors Worship Ceremony scheduled to take place on January 1, 2019 at the Taiwan Linkou Stadium. 36,000 participants will sing along as well as 10 directions of Dharma realm springs. Through music and Dharma, mental tranquility is provided to both members of the underworld and the human world. A course performance took place on October 27th at the Tanjishan Xianfu Temple in the hopes of gathering more virtuous pharaohs to join Weixin World Courts, make vocal offerings, and beautify the world with music.
Weixin World Chorus held the Council of the Heart of the Buddha, making an offering with voice at Zaozen Buddha Zen held on October 27th, and the worship to Wang Chan Lao Tzu and Buddha with voice. Grandmaster Hu Yuan Chan Shi and virtuous fellows of Weixin Shenjiao Lecture Training Program also listened to the moving chorus performance. Weixin World Chorus used the sound to convey the meaning of Weixin Shenjiao and to practice the cultivation of art in the singing. Chorus music is not only the chanting and performance of aesthetic education, but also an excellent chanting of group education. It is also the achievement of learning to undertake the division of work and the coordination of each other. Under the harmony of singing and music, singing together shows the power of soul and has more emergence and construct so that the audience can feel the emotions and the vitality of facial expressions of the performances on the stage. The concert performed a series of songs such as 天山明月, 游子吟, 城南Farewell, 余家乐, 康定Love Song, and 四季唱农家. Grandmaster Hu Yuan Chan Shi also instructed
每年的祭祖大典都有个表演，一年比一年的好啊，所以今年啊，我们的祭祖大典还是要以歌声来供养那些老祖宗啊，以声供养，即心即佛，佛就有智慧者，有智慧者唱出的心声来供养那些老祖先。啊，所以叫做全民共舞，啊，绵阳两界共舞，啊，那我们到明年1月1号，在林口大体育馆，啊，还是一样，然后负责奉请祖灵，啊，和奉送祖灵，还有中间那里，以身供养。带大家来感恩，来会心会灵，好，今天唱得非常好。
Weixin World Chorus performance was a complete success. Weixin News at Xianfu Temple.
Grandmaster Wen Yuan Chan Shi enlightened us with the profound wisdom of Yi Jing Feng Shui in simple language. He integrates the art of the divination.Unveils the mysteries of Yi Jing Feng Shui and creates a wonderful life for you and me based on a righteous religion. Thank you for joining us today. Please stay tuned at 11:30 p.m. on every Monday. You can also catch us at 11:30 in the morning and 4 o'clock in the afternoon on every Tuesday for our Weixin News on Weixin TV.Bless you and your family. World peace. See you next week.